सर, द मल्टीनेशनल कंपनी दैट वी हैव चूज इज लार्सन्स एंड टूब्रो. सो नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू अ ब्रीफ अबाउट द हिस्ट्री. लार्सन एंड टूब्रो ओरिजिनेटेड फ्रॉम अ कंपनी फाउंडेड इन 1938 इन मुंबई बाई टू दानिश इंजीनियर्स हेनिंग हॉक लार्सन एंड सॉरेन क्रिस्टिन टूब्रो. द कंपनी बिगेन एज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ दानिश मैन्युफैक्चरर्स ऑफ डेयरी एंड अलाइड इक्विपमेंट्स, बट दे हैड टू स्टॉप इन 1940 बिकॉज ऑफ द जर्मन इन्वेजन. इन 1944 ई सी सी इंजीनियरिंग कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड कॉन्ट्रैक्ट्स वॉज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड बाई द पार्टनर्स. द कंपनी एट दिस टाइम वॉज फोकस्ड ऑन कंस्ट्रक्शन प्रोजेक्ट्स. इन 1945 द कंपनी साइंड एन अग्रीमेंट विद कैटरपिलर ट्रैक्टर कंपनी इन द यू एस ए फॉर मार्केटिंग अर्थ मूविंग इक्विपमेंट्स. लार्ज नंबर ऑफ कैटरपिलर इक्विपमेंट्स वर अवेलेबल एट वेरी अट्रैक्टिव प्राइजेज when the war ended, but the finances required were beyond the capacity of the partners. This prompted them to raise additional equity capital, and on 7th February 1946, L&T Private Limited was incorporated. After India's independence in 1947, the firm set up offices in Calcutta, Madras and New Delhi. In 1948, 55 acres of undeveloped land was acquired in Powai in Mumbai. In December 1950, L&T became a public company with a paid capital of 20 lakh rupees. In 1956, a major part of company's Mumbai office moved to ICI House in Ballard Estate. In 1965, the firm had been chosen as a partner for building nuclear reactors. In 1970, L&T was contracted to work with Indian Space Research Organization called as the ISRO. In 1976, ECC bid for a large airport project in Abu Dhabi. In 1985, L&T entered into a partnership with Defense Research and Development Organization called the DRDO. After a series of success and positive policy initiatives, the firm today makes a range of weapons and missile systems, command and control systems, engineering systems and submarines through DRDO. The products and services that L&T provides are construction, building and factories, heavy civil infrastructure, transportation infrastructure, power transmission and distribution, water and effluent treatment, metallurgical and material handling, renewable energy, that is L&T solar. Coming to L&T construction, it is one of the world's top 15 contractors. The business involves the construction of buildings and factories, heavy civil infrastructure, transportation infrastructure, power transmission and distribution infrastructure, water and effluent treatment plants, metallurgical and material handling infrastructure, and smart world and communication infrastructure. Buildings and factories undertakes construction projects such as commercial buildings and airports, residential buildings and factories. Its track record includes 400 high-rise towers, 11 airports, 53 IT parks, 17 automobile plants, 28 cement plants and 45 hospitals. L&T's heavy civil infrastructure business undertakes projects in the areas of hydel power, tunnel, nuclear power, special bridges, metros, ports, harbors and defense installations. Its track record includes 231 kilometers of metro rail corridors, 19.5 kilometers of monorail corridors, 8,315 megawatt of hydropower projects, and 8,080 megawatt of nuclear projects. Transportation infrastructure business undertakes projects such as roads, runways, elevated corridors, railways, etc. Its track record includes 13,500 lane of highways, 7.49 million square meters of runways, and 3,260 track kilometers of railway tracks. It also operates through subsidiaries such as L&T Oman LLC, L&T Infrastructure Engineering Limited, and Hi-Tech Rock Products and Aggregates Limited. L&T's power transmission distribution business involves the construction of substations, utility power distribution systems, transmission lines, and optic fiber cabling projects. L&T's water and effluent treatment business involves water supply and distribution, wastage water treatment, industrial and large water systems, and smart water infrastructure. Its track record includes 40,000 kilometers of water and wastewater network and 3,400 million of liters per day of water and wastage treatment plants. L&T also undertakes projects in the ferrous and non-ferrous sectors. It offers EPC solutions in bulk material handling for the coal sector. Its industrial machinery and cast projects business offer fabrication, machining, assembly and casting products for industries such as chemical, cement, steel, paper, power, mineral and railways. Lastly, we have L&T Renewable Energy. So, L&T develops concentrated solar power and solar photovoltaic technologies. In April 2012, L&T commissioned India's largest solar photovoltaic power plant owned by Reliance Power at Jaisalmer, Rajasthan. From concept to commissioning in 129 days, in 2012, L&T entered into a partnership with Sharp for engineering, procurement and construction in megawatt solar project and plan to construct about 100 megawatt in the next 12 months. Now I'm going to give you a product briefing. So L&T has a very vast sector of the products. So one example of L&T which I would like to give is L&T Electrical and Automation. So under Electrical and Automation, there are ACB, air circuit breakers. Omega ACBs are the next generation circuit breaker with advanced protection features designed to protect an electrical system from damage caused by excess current from an overload or short circuit and equipment ground faults. It ranges from 400 amperes to 6300 amperes, braking capacity from 50 kiloampere to 100 kiloamperes, available in 4 pole, manually and electrically operated, fixed and draw out versions, conforms to glow wire testing, temperature protection by monitoring true terminal temperature, 3 compact frame sizes help in optimizing the switchboard, true 50% and 200% neutral solution for specific user application, supports multi-tire arrangement with minimum clearance with the help of arc shield, self-aligning, snap fit, secondary isolating contacts, enable quick termination. Secondly, I would like to take MPCB motor protection circuit breakers. Supernova series motor protection circuit breakers from L&T Electrical and Automation integrates functions of MCCB and thermal overload relay into a highly compact single unit. Equipped with a wide range current adjustment dial, the MPCB easily adjusts to match the rated current of the motor for optimum protection. MPCB provides protection against short circuit and overload. It has amazing compactness, high braking capacity, short circuit protective coordination, reduction in wiring work, ecological design standards, standard accessories for all frames of MPCB, wide range of accessories which suits your requirement, IP20 terminal cover prevents accidental contact to electrically charged part, auxiliary contact blocks, alarm contact blocks, auxiliary and alarm contact blocks, shunt tripped device.
L&T annual report analysis. Annual report are basically prepared by companies which are sent to shareholders. It is also submitted to various users such as bankers, investors and government authorities. It covers a financial year period. L&T operating income during the year fell 6.5% on a year-on-year basis, and income statement analysis is basically summarizes all income and expenses over a given period. Income statements are often shared as quarterly and annual basis, showing the financial trends and comparisons over time. The net profit for the year 2020 and 2021 grew by 19.3% on year-on-year basis, and the other incomes grew by 190.1%. The net profit margins during the year grew from 7.2% to 8.7%. Cash flow statement analysis. The purpose of cash flow statement is to provide a detailed picture of what happened to a business cash during a specified period known as accounting period. It demonstrates an organization's ability to operate in short and long term based on how much cash is flowing into and out of the business. The cash flow statements is typically broken into three sections, which are operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. So the cash flow from investing activities of L&T during the year 2021 stood at 54 billion, and the cash flow from financial activities during year 2021 stood at 153 billion, and cash flow from operating activities stood at 228 billion with an improvement of 241.3% on a year-on-year basis. So the overall net cash flow for the company during the year 2021 stood at 21 billion from 47 billion net cash flow. Share price performance. So share and the share price performance means basically the increase in the market or the fair market value of common stock, or the increase in the price at which the company sell the shares of common stock. So over the last year, L&T share price has moved up from rupees 904.6 to 1600, which is approximately a gain of rupees 695.5 or around 76.9%. And the overall Sensex is up to 39.6% over the year. Ratio analysis of L&T. Current ratio. So the current ratio measures the company's ability to pay short-term and long-term obligations. The company's current ratio has improved from 1.3 to 1.4. There is also another kind of ratio analysis that is being done, which is known as interest coverage ratio. So the interest coverage ratio of a company states how easily a company can pay its interest expense at an outstanding debt. The higher the ratio, it is preferable. And L&T's company's interest coverage ratio has improved from 2.3 to 2.6.
Talking about the CSR activities, CSR basically means corporate social responsibility. So we have five bottom line concepts of CSR. Firstly, we have responsibility towards the employee. Secondly, responsibility towards society. Thirdly, responsibility towards consumers. Fourth, responsibility towards shareholders. And lastly, responsibility towards the government. So the CSR activities carried out by L&T Financial Services are, firstly, water intervention. So the intervention schemes involve water and soil conservation, construction like dams and any cuts, contour trenches, farm bunds and farm ponds lead to an increase in the water level, help in retaining moisture in the soil. Then we have WASH initiatives. L&T provides training to the youth in Manzori skills, encourage the usage of local materials to construct well-designed toilet cum bathrooms in villages and schools, open defecation-free drive impact has been huge, which has benefited 40 hamlets, 11 revenue villages and 2 gram panchayats, which include 1008 families. Then we have education. In 2018-19, L&T supported more than 400 schools and reached out to over 2.4 lakh children with its education initiatives pan India. They ensure sustainable development of communities and contribute to strengthening education and social infrastructure. They provide support for better learning abilities of young minds and supplement learning in school. Lastly, Larsen & Toubro Health CSR Interventions. L&T CSR works in collaboration with the government in the field of family welfare, mother and child health, HIV, AIDS, tuberculosis, blindness control, diabetes detection and treatment, and reproductive health services. They run health centers in multiple parts of the country, which have well-qualified doctors and rehabilitation consultants. Provide family counseling services that help address mental health and stress-related issues. They run a huge facility in the Andheri suburb of Mumbai, which completed 50 years of service.
L&T, India's largest engineering and construction company, expects to double its revenue in 5 years as it focuses on sunrise sectors such as defense and explores new markets such as Africa. Reducing subsidiary units and simplifying its management structure will also help sharpen its focus. In 5 years, starting from 2016, L&T grew its revenue at 14.5% annually despite a slowdown in its economy. As a part of 5-year strategic plan, by 2021, L&T is expecting to expand margins by 100 to 120 basis point, or we can call it BPS. Explaining the company's strategic 5-year plan named Lakshya, R. S. Raman, the Chief Financial Officer, that is CFO of L&T, said, few states are preparing for elections in next 2 years, while the center will have general election in 2019. We are expecting bulk orders in next 5 years, giving us 15% year-on-year growth. He said, the plan will not have brand new things, barring defense manufacturing and nuclear power equipment manufacturing, and that's assuming that the government will place large orders in the coming years. He also said that we will stay focused on construction and engineering, which is the core of our business, and specialized high-tech manufacturing and key services businesses. Raman said, the company will remain a 70 to 30 ratio for revenues for a domestic and international market, respectively. As domestic order flows started more, L&T started focusing more on international market since 2010. L&T's financial results show that this international focus has paid off. From just under 1/10 a few years ago, the international business now contributes to almost 1/3 of both orders, inflows and revenues. In the June quarter, while domestic order inflows declined 9.7% from a year ago, international orders rose to 14%. Given the kind of size L&T has attained, it would be difficult for domestic business alone to support the order book and top-line growth investors would be satisfied with, said Pankaj Sharma, head of the investment banking and consulting firm. But there is more to Lakshya. One of the key objectives of the 5-year plan is to enable all growth companies to independent management structures. Now, L&T operates through a complex structure of 82 business units and has seen its return to shareholders nearly half between 2008 and 2015 due to misallocation of capital in various low-return businesses. It now wants to make up for the past mistakes by reducing working capital over the next 5 years. Some of the recent achievements of L&T are L&T Hydrocarbon Engineering, that is LTHE, was ranked as the top EPC contractor in the Middle East by Oil and Gas Middle East magazine, which is the region's leading publication which focuses on oil and gas industry. L&T was also ranked as fourth on LinkedIn in year 2021 in the top companies list in India. It was one of the only companies in infrastructure which was featured in top 10. L&T was also given the prestigious HR Excellence Award in the Innovation in Onboarding category for its first ever virtual GET, or we can say PGET, onboarding program named Prayag. The award was given by the Economic Times HR World in collaboration with the OLX people. L&T Hydrocarbon Engineering also won the Engineering Procurement Construction, that is EPC Company of the Year Award, which was given to the company in 2020. In year 2020, L&T won the CNBC TV18's prestigious Firm of the Year trophy for the best risk management practices for frameworks and systems. L&T has been was given the Company of the Year by the Business Daily Standard.